Hey, so today I'm going to teach you guys different drive methods for the demo drivetrain that we've made videos on how to make. And the first one that I'm going to show you is tank drive. And essentially what tank drive is you have each side of your robot controlled by the joystick. So the left side of the left motor is going to be controlled by the left joystick, and the right motor is going to be controlled by the right joystick. And this is the simplest way to program your drivetrain. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to the blocks menu, and I'm going to create a new op mode and call this first global tank drive. And I'm going to create it. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to first set our motor power to 0. And I'm going to. Okay, next what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually have to reverse our left motor, so I'm going to have to set right drive dot dir direction or sorry left drive dot direction to reverse. And the reason this is happening is because our drive motors are pointed in different directions, meaning that they're gonna go in opposite ways if I set both power to 1. And in order to counter this, I just have to reverse one of the motors. The last thing that I have to do is I have to set both the motors to brake, so that when I set 0 power to them, they're gonna stop and not go on. Okay, now I've gotten our initialization done. I'm going to actually set the motor power. So I'm gonna go to DC motor. Set right drive dot power to gamepad 1 dot right stick Y. And now I'm gonna go for our left drive. So set left drive dot power to gamepad 1 dot left stick Y. And this is all there is to a tank drive. So now I'm going to test it. Okay, so now I have gotten the program loaded, and the reason this is a phone is just because we don't have enough parts to have multiple control hubs and fire tablets. And so you can see I have first global tank drive selected. I'm just gonna hit init and play. And now I'm going to see, you can see the robot's there. And as I hit control the left stick, you can see that the left motors move, and as I move the right stick, the right motors move. And so one thing that is bad about this is that you can see that the robot is really fast and is prone to tipping, which makes it hard to drive. Okay, now I'm going to make the tank drive a little slower, and how I'm going to do this is I'm going to have a variable called power gain. So I'm going to create it, and this is just going to be a constant, and I'm going to set power gain to 0.5 for now. So I'm going to set it to 0.5. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to multiply my gamepad 1 dot right stick Y and gamepad 1 dot left stick Y, the powers of each side, by power gain to make it go a little slower. So I'm going to take this out and put a math block, and I'm going to do multiply. Times. And so this is going to make it go at half the speed. And so here is what it's going to be. And I'm just going to save this and I'll show you the difference in how much easier it is to drive.
Okay, now again, I have first global tank drive selected. And I'm just gonna hit init and play. And now you can see again it's a tank drive. So here you have it. And you can see I'm going at full speed, and yet it's only going at half speed, which makes it a lot easier to drive. Okay, now though tank drive is a pretty easy way to control the robot, for programming wise, I'm going to show you an easier way.
Okay, now that easier way that I just talked about is called arcade drive. And essentially what this is it's a more intuitive way to drive. So one joystick on the y-axis controls the throttle of the robot, and that means forward and backward. And the x-axis, meaning left and right of that joystick, controls the turning. And this is a lot easier for a lot of drivers. So where I'm gonna go is I'm gonna go to blocks, and I'm going to select this op mode, and I'm gonna make a copy of it and call it First Global Arcade Drive. And the reason I'm making a copy is because the init code, the initialization code of this is correct. And then I'm just gonna delete this. And so again, I'm setting the powers of zero, reversing the correct motor, and then setting them both to brake. And then I also still have power gain. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go to actuators, DC motor, and set right drive dot power to, and I'm gonna go to math and have a plus block. And I'm gonna have gamepad one dot right stick Y, which is going to be the throttle, plus gamepad one, sorry, plus gamepad one dot right stick X. And what this is going to do is it's going to set the right drive power to the right stick Y plus the right stick X, meaning it's gonna go forward and backward, and then the plus right stick X mean it's gonna go forward when right stick X is po positive. And so I'm gonna set the left drive to this, except times minus left stick X. And so I'm just going to change that to a minus. And though this might look good, I for just forgot to do one thing, and that is adding the power gain variable, as otherwise it's going to be really hard to drive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a math block and multiplication, and I'm going to put that into the multiplication, and I'm going to put variables power gain in there. And I'm going to put this in there and copy this. And there you have it. That's our arcade drive. Now I'll show you me testing it.
Okay, now I have the first global arcade drive loaded, and I'm just gonna hit init and play. And now arcade drive works where I have my right stick controlling everything. So you can see as I go forward and backward, it moves the robot forward and backward, and then as I turn, it turns the robot. So that means that I can like go forward and while turning and do lots of neat moves. And this is a lot easier for most drivers as it's pretty intuitive.